Now I'm going to show you some special states of the Cobalt console that you can use when working with moving lights or with intensity channels. The first one we're going to show is highlight. Highlight is something that you often use with moving lights. So I'm going to turn on some channels as an example. And highlight is a mode that you use in order to identify fixtures within a larger stage look or within a larger grouping. I'll turn these lights to a dimmer value, and I'm going to give them a dark color as well in this case to help show the difference between a highlighted light and one that's being ignored at the moment. When I enable the highlight mode by hitting the highlight key on the face panel, you're going to see these 12 lights go from their dim dark blue values to their highlight values, and the highlight values are stored within the template of the fixture. When you're in highlight, you'll see a highlight indicator on all the screens connected to your console. It's very important to know you're in highlight because if I select another group right now, expecting to just add them to the look somehow, what happens is that these lights are going to go out of highlight, and the new group is going to go into highlight, which means all of them are going to get pushed very often to a very bright level in a stunning and spectacular way. Most of the time you end up doing this and going, oh shoot, highlight's on. Because what you really expected was just to select some channels subtly and then bring them up on an intensity wheel on your own. Every time you select something while you're in highlight, the selection is forced into the highlight state. Moving on from here though, now that I've got my grouping selected, I can start using the next and last tools to work through my group one by one. I use highlight often when I'm setting up my focus palettes because now I can see each individual light to get them into position, and I know which ones I've done already and which ones I haven't. In this particular case, I'm looking at the highlight state and thinking, it might be better to do this with a tight zoom or a small iris. So I can change the highlight value for this light by going into its template through the browser. Now I can look for the zoom parameter, for example, and find the highlight column and change the definition of this fixture to do a highlight value that's got a very tight zoom. This is also recommended when you're doing your focus positions because now you know the center of the beam is actually going to hit a person standing at that particular focus position and not end up aimed behind their knees, for example. So now as I go from one light to the next using the next key, you'll see it jumps into the highlight state and the previous light jumps out of the highlight state and back to where it was set before. This is a really good way for identifying lights that are doing the thing you want or not doing the thing you want, so you can find them and adjust them quickly without ruining your actual programming. And what I mean by that is I can go out of the highlight state now and the light goes right back to where you had set it before. Some other tools I can use with intensity, meaning I can use them with dimmer channels and not just with moving lights, include the RemDim, Balance, and Compare functions. RemDim is a command, not a state. So if I want at this point to take those two center lights, which I know are channels 3 and 4, and select them and get rid of everybody else on stage, I can hit the RemDim key and force all the other lights that are on to turn off. And I'm left just with my current selection at their current settings. And now I can work with these lights however I want to. Unlike other systems, RemDim is not a state of the desk. You don't see any warnings on the screen saying you're in RemDim mode. That's because RemDim is a command. It says, make sure that the remainder on stage dims out. If I hit RemDim again, I don't get those lights back. If you're more used to working with a RemDim function where the lights do come back, in Cobalt, that function is called Balance. Balance is a soft key that you find under the channel's soft keys. So let's recreate that look using the balance mode instead. I select the two lights that I want to work with, channels 3 and 4, and I hit the balance soft key or click it with a mouse instead. Now you can see balance is indicated on the screens. I can do what I want with these lights, change their color, for example, do whatever I want. And when I'm done making those adjustments to those specific channels, I hit balance again or click on it with the mouse, and all the remaining lights come back. If you don't ever want to use RemDim as a command and you'd prefer to use RemDim as a balance button, you can change its function by holding setup and hitting RemDim and then ticking the box. Now when I hit RemDim, it enables balance mode. And when I hit RemDim again, it disables the balance mode. Another tool when working with intensities is the compare mode. And compare mode lets you make adjustments to intensity values on stage, like in a theatrical production, and then determine whether or not you preferred the old look to the new look. Compare is a soft key under the channels menu. And when I click compare, I'm going to go between the old recorded look, the look that's in the A fader, and the new manual adjustments I've just made, which in this case is the yellow light's a little brighter. And this way I can say, after making a bunch of changes, is that the right thing to do? And just look at what was previously recorded and what I've changed so that I know with some confidence that I actually want to hit the update key. In this case, I like it, so I'll update it into the look. And that's compare mode.